One thing people can get smarter, faster about is the importance of blockchain in humanitarian efforts. If you think about a bank or a government, they use a central database to store records. There's not much to hold these actors accountable. We really just have to trust them. A blockchain is essentially a decentralized, distributed digital ledger. Think of it like a giant Google spreadsheet that's shared with many people with one major difference. You can't modify any of the existing rows without altering all of the rows preceding it. Because that spreadsheet is shared with lots of people, it's actually pretty easy to identify if any of the rows have been changed. You've probably heard about it in reference to Bitcoin or other forms of cryptocurrency as a way to store and transact financial value, but it can also be used for humanitarian response and international development. This technology is just starting to be used to do things like manage supply chains better, store land titles or medical records digitally, support new types of ID systems for refugees, improve voting processes, and deliver aid in times of crisis. I would say it's particularly useful in countries and contexts where the actors, like governments, banks, NGOs, mobile network operators, the UN system, where they don't trust each other. This is often a big challenge in humanitarian response. It matters because blockchain technology allows them to achieve that consensus around data without having to share trust. That means faster and more transparent delivery of aid, less fraud, and fewer disputes.